Hey, Snackers. In episode 32 of DevNet Snack Minute, Matt and Kareem talk with Joe Clark, distinguished engineer in Cisco Learning and Certifications, about Cisco Modeling Labs.
Hey, Snackers. I'm Matt DiNapoli. I'm one of the managers of developer advocacy with Cisco DevNet.
Hello, Snackers. This is Kareem Iskander. I'm a technical advocate with Cisco Learning and Certification.
Welcome to episode 32 of DevNet Snack Minutes.
DevNet Snack Minute is your weekly 10 minutes, all things DevNet, giving you a quick, easy, fun way to learn about Cisco APIs. Coding is just some cool stuff that we do here at DevNet.
And in this episode today, we're extending our sandbox series, and we're going to be talking to one of our guests, Joe, about Cisco Modeling Labs. But Joe, could you introduce yourself, please?
Sure. Hi. Hi, Snackers. I'm Joe Clark. I'm a distinguished engineer in the learning and certifications group at Cisco. Been here, well, at Cisco about 23 years and learning for about 3 years now. And among other things, I've been helping with our Cisco Modeling Labs team on architecture stuff, talking to customers, just getting the word out about how cool this product is.
Joe, talk to us a little bit about what is CML and how is it helpful and beneficial to our developers?
Sure. So you've in episode 30 and episodes 30 and 31, I guess you guys went over Sandbox and showed how you can get into Cisco network devices. You can play around with them, test out the APIs, test out the automation capabilities. And all of that is backed by Cisco Modeling Labs. Cisco Modeling Labs presents an orchestration layer across what we call our virtual reference platform. So virtual instances of iOS, XR, XE, NXOS, ASAV, amongst others like SD-WAN. And the advantages of being able to do that are you can play with these and get comfortable with these networking technologies and operating systems in a safe environment. You can test out, hey, I'm just learning RESTConf or NetConf, or I'd like to play with this thing I've heard called telemetry. How can I do that? And CML, DevNet Sandbox and CML by extension gives you that capability to very easily test out those APIs. CML itself was built with an API first mentality. So that means that everything that you do when you're in Sandbox and if you're with the CML Sandbox or with any of the sandboxes that you're interacting with, these devices were all added to this canvas, added to this this topology by just dragging and dropping. We did it via the UI, but you can programmatically, via the REST API that CML provides, add all of these devices. You could build this topology from scratch just with those APIs. And then taking that a step further, once you got that topology up, then you can bring in your Ansibles, your Terraforms, or Cisco NSO to play with all the automation capabilities of the devices themselves. So CML is really a blank canvas for being able to do whatever you need, play with whatever you need in terms of learning and getting comfortable with automation and our programmatic interfaces.
That's really interesting that you talked about being able to build these things out from API, because then that leads me to the question, and I think I know the answer, but this means that we can then set up virtual environments that mimic our physical environments, but then we can set those up as basically infrastructure as code as well. We've been talking a lot about infrastructure as code around DevNet, and this just now takes the production and physical environment and moves it to a space where we can kind of test it safely. Do I have that right?
You have it absolutely right. In fact, what you're seeing here is exactly that. This is called the Design Validation Test Network that this lab is. What this represents is the Learning and Certification Data Center Lab that we're re-architecting from scratch. If you've ever taken a course from Cisco, CCNA training or product training, and you jumped into a lab with that, and you were interacting with a device, well, you need a data center to be able to host those virtual devices or sometimes physical devices. And so we have a couple of data centers. We have one in RTP and one in San Jose. They were built and they're operated fairly manually today. So what we want to do is ratchet that up a notch and bring in a whole net DevOps infrastructure as code mindset from the ground up. And so what we've done is modeled that whole lab here in CML. This is built all using virtual CSRs to stand for what will be ASRs, or sorry, CSRs to stand for what will be ASRs, virtual Nexus 9Ks for what will be physical Nexus 9Ks, virtual firepower threat defense firewalls, virtual ASAs. They will stand for physical gear in our production topology. And what this allows us to do then is use Cisco NSO to deploy our service configuration. And I've actually just been playing with, I've been creating a service right now to do DNS management. So some of the common networking features. So I've created a service in NSO and I've deployed that service to this device. So there's this external connectivity allows us to have my NSO instance I'm developing out in a container, in a Docker container in a development machine. It connects into here through the management interface and I can configure my devices. And we're doing all of that to test out, does our network architecture work? And once we do that and get comfortable in CML, then we can start to move that towards production. But CML enables all of this to happen. And over here in GitLab, we've got the CML topology. So I've got this this lab actually in YAML, so I can export it into YAML. I've got all of that network pre-configured with its day zero configuration, and then I can programmatically deploy this network into any instance of CML I want. So it's absolutely, like you said, Matt, it's ripe for infrastructure as code. It's a great tool for that.
This is awesome. Tell us a little bit about how do I get started with CML? Where do I go? And you know, if I'm interested in getting this for myself, what can I do?
Real quick on your last point, if you go out to our Cisco DevNet GitHub site, there is a CML community. Here you'll find various use cases, one of which I've published called CML CICD, which exactly, Kareem, what you just described. Now, how can you get started with CML yourself? We have two main flavors. We have a personal edition, and that's available from our CLN store. The Cisco Modeling Labs personal edition, you can come out to the CLN store. This the regular personal edition gives you 20 nodes. There's a personal plus for $350 that gives you up to 40 nodes that you can run. And then we also have an enterprise focused version that's really what we're seeing some of our larger customers take on to start to experience that infrastructure as code, to start to really thread automation into their practices. And CML Enterprise is available from our global price list. So talk to your account managers and we can hook you up with evaluation licenses and we can set up some time with you to discuss more of the capabilities and the features. CML Personal has a community support behind it. So you can go to the Learning Network and ask questions about that. CML Enterprise comes with full-on Cisco Enterprise tax support.
If you guys want to get your hands dirty with Cisco Modeling Labs before committing to buy, you can check that out in the DevNet Sandbox as well. And I believe we have the enterprise version available. It's just for a limited time for the reservations that we can have for the DevNet Sandbox.
That's right. We've got the DevNet Sandbox. In fact, as of, I believe, yesterday, we were helping the Sandbox team upgrade CML. So if you come to DevNet Sandbox and you scroll down, you'll see that there's CML. We have both personal and enterprise. And while this is being a little bit slow to load, we just upgraded it, or the team just upgraded it to 2.2.2, which is our latest version. So previously we're 2.0. There's been a lot of cool enhancements around packet capture, programmatic link conditioning. A lot of bugs have been fixed. And we've got a 2.3 release around the corner that's going to add a new canvas, a new topology canvas, and we'll finally get .1Q subinterface support natively back for the CSR 1000V.
And Snackers, if you're not familiar with the DevNet Sandbox and the catalog, how to access it, check out episode 30 of our Snack Minute where Matt walked us through all of that. And super simple, super easy, free for you. But you can definitely check it out. And with that, Matt, do you want to ask Joe the infamous question?
No, you ask him the infamous question.
All right. Joe, we do this with all our guests. And if you have one to pick one superpower, what would that be and why?
I am a pilot, so flying would be natural, but I can already do that. So immortality is my superpower. I've always wanted to, not for always, I guess I've for a long time wanted to live forever, simply because I think that there's always going to be something else to see and something interesting that's always going to be there for humanity. So I figure if I could live, not like age forever, not like, oh, I'm so old, I'm a visual, but actually like be like Highlander style. Like I'm Connor McLeod of the Clan McLeod, and I cannot die, that type of thing. You're young, you're vibrant, and you can live forever. I think that would be pretty cool.
I think there's definitely a more philosophical and deeper discussion that needs to go into the superpower, but it's pretty awesome. Snackers, I appreciate your time today. Thanks, Joe, for joining us. This has been another episode of DevNet Snack Minute. Join us next week on a new topic.